Hello friends, welcome to our YouTube channel. So in the previous class we have discussed the strength of material, that is the second class, and we have discussed almost more than 35 questions we have covered with the problems also, because day by day I am increasing the problems also, right? So if you didn't watch our previous class, please click on the I button so that you will get the our previous class link, right? If you want to see all our different videos, please visit the 1 minute. Okay. Please visit our playlist that is in the name of Strength of Material Previous Year Question. I have already created playlist in my YouTube channel. And who are visiting first time to our YouTube channel, please welcome to our YouTube channel. Here you can learn about the different civil engineering different subjects as well as the civil engineering job related notifications. So today's class is, that is a class 3, I think, right? So the class 3 only. We all, in previous class we have completed 35 plus questions, totally more than 100 questions already covered on the strength of material. Let me see more questions on the strength of material, that is on the material as well as stress and strain. On the topic of this we will discuss. So today's first class, today's first question, factor of safety is defined as a ratio of, it is always defined as an ultimate stress to working stress. Remember this one, this is the repeated question they are asking. Factor of safety is defined as an ultimate stress to working stress. Question number 2, today's second question, which material has the highest value of Poisson's ratio? They are asking the highest value of Poisson's ratio, right? Highest value is always, that is about the rubber, right? Rubber is having highest Poisson's ratio, right? You can see rubber, copper is 0.33, steel 0.27 to 0.3, wood is 0.25. What is the minimum value? The cork is having the minimum value, that is a 0. Concrete is 0.1 to 0.2 and cast iron is 0.2 to 0.3. You have to remember these results, right? They may ask the question on this one. Don't think that this type of question only ask in JE. They may ask in AE also, right? Don't think that they may ask only in JE or any lower, that is up to diploma level. They may ask any type of question to any degree, right? Next question. In a composite system subjected to temperature rise, right? So temperature rise and with ends constrained to remain together. Ends constrained means they have tagged to each other, right? The component having lower value of coefficient of linear expansion will experience. Composite system means, first of all understand, composite system means number of two, right? One material, two material. When you add this one, it will get composite system. When we have two different components, when we combine, for example, steel and aluminium. For example, steel and aluminium. So they are asking end restraint. So the ends are restrained means ends are tie up. In previous class, we have already done this type of question. That is the question they have given. The component having lower value of coefficient of linear expansion. For example, aluminium and steel. Right? So let me take. So this is a material 1. This is a material, material 2. This one should be material 2. Right? So the temperature increases. So the composite bar. So the compression will be, because this is a any one material, this is a compressive and this is a tension. Right? So this is the initial position and this is the final position of that material. Means what? The lower linear expansion will be experienced by the tensile stress. Right? So that is a tensile stress. Remember this one. These are the concept based questions. Concept based questions you have to remember. Please remember by this sketch. You can easily understand. Next question. The force acting normally on a cross section of a bar shown in the figure below introduce. Right? Shown in the bar introduce what? It always the tensile stress. How? Right? Let me see. This is the bar. Right? Already we have applied the load here, right? This end is fixed, means the load will goes like this. So this is a tensile stress. If the load, if this is a member, if you are applying load like this, right, then this is a compression, this is a tension. So the answer for this question is tensile force. You can see this is tensile, this is compression, and this is shear stress when it goes in the sideways. Next question. A material is said to be perfectly elastic when it regain its original shape and size, or what? Elastic material we are asking, right? Elastic material means it regain its original shape on removal of the load. Plastic and elastic, there are two different concepts you have to remember. When you remove, it will not recover, it will recover. Only simple concept you have to remember. Okay, so it is perfectly elastic, if regain its original shape of removal of the load, that will be the curve of OABAO. OABAO again, at any time of loading or unloading. So the A is a proportionality limit here, this one, and it obeys Hooke's law till the point that is A up to E. Elastic limit, B is a elastic limit. Beyond point B, curve BAO will not be traced, right? Next question. AB and AC are the cross sections of a bronze and copper, right? So there are two different materials they have given. One is bronze. Okay, let me write here. Okay, sorry. One is bronze, one is copper, right? Bars of equal length, both are having equal length. We can say that is a equal to length. Toby and Tosi are the, their Toby and Tosi are the respective stresses. They are stress due to the load P. Load is P. If PB and PC are the load shared by them, then, right? For this, you have to first remember, this is a bronze, right? So this is a bronze and this is a copper, and this is a L and this is also L, right? If you applied load at this point, right, this is a cross section. Free body diagram, we can say, when we considering the free body diagram, right, it will come like this, PB and PC, and this is a main stresses. This is a question they have given, but P, you can see the load, PB and PC are the load shared by them, means they are both are shared by equal. So the P is equal to PB plus PC. So the PB is Toby and AB, right? I have written already here, Toby and Tosi are stresses they have given, right? So the Toby also. So the total P is equal to Toby plus AB plus Tosi into AC. So the strain in both the rods will be same, because they have shared by them, they are equally shared by them, right? So the Toby by Tosi is equal to EB by EC. So this equation, right, for example, you can see the, now see the options, Toby by Tosi, EB by EC, this one also correct. P is equal to PB plus PC, this one also correct, and the third one also, right, correct answer. So the all options are correct, right? If you want more, you can pause this video and take the screenshot of this one. Next question. If the question is not visible, I will read, don't worry. The load of 1960 newton is raised at the end of a steel wire. Steel wire, right? Load is 1960 newton. The minimum diameter of the wire, so that the stress in the wire does not exceed 100 newton per millimeter square. This is a stress they have given, right? So what we have to calculate? The minimum diameter. It is simple, as simple. Load is equal to stress into area of the cross section. Let me write here. Load is equal to stress into cross sectional area, right? So that is, the load is 1960. And the stress is 100 into area is pi by 4 d square. Now d is the value, that is a 5 mm is the answer for this question, right? 5 mm is the answer for this question, you have to remember. Very simple questions they may ask, but if you know the concepts, then you can answer. Right, next. A bar L meter long and having its area of cross sectional A. L area is A, subjected to a gradually applied tensile load. Tensile load W. The strain energy stored in the bar. They are asking the strain energy. So which load gradually they are taking? They are asking about the gradually. In this type of question, there are two different aspects. One is gradually, one is suddenly. In previous class also I have discussed these two, right? Gradually, if gradually comes, right, if gradually comes, we will take that is as an what? Half into W into delta L. This is what? The area under load deformation curve. Means half is due to, right, it will already I have discussed, right, it will come like this, right? Only 50% of the stress strain curve we have to take. 50% of stress strain curve we will take in the what? This gradually. In suddenly we have to take 100%. So that's why we are taking half W, right, into delta L. So the D is the answer for. Okay, 1 minute, 1 minute. Right, so this is, okay, wait. I will give you the correct answer for this question. Don't worry. 1 minute. So what is the question actually? That is, yes, this one. Right. So after half into W into delta L, next portion I will write here. Don't worry. So delta is equal to E into E. That is the, sorry, weight load by area, that is stress, right, E into delta L into L. This is a strain, right? So delta L is equal to what? W L by A E. W L by A E. By putting in this equation, right, by putting the equation in this one, this is first, right? So what you will get? That is U is equal to half into W into W L by A E, right? So the answer is W square L by 2 A E. I think you got, right? First of all, what you have to do? You have to do the area under load deformation curve, right? This one. So that is a half into W into delta L. After that, this portion you have to remember, this 50% portion we have to take, right? So this is a stress strain curve. After that, we have to start from here, right? We know that the stress is equal to this one, and this is what stress, and this is what strain. When we equate and when we put this value in the equation 1, we will get the answer for this question. Okay, have you got the answer? Simple question, you have to remember this one. Next, when the load is transferred through the one surface to another, when the load is transferred through one surface to another surface in contact, the stress is known as, right, the stress is always known as, that is a shearing stress, right, shearing stress. Assuming the value of maximum deviation delta P, assuming the value of maximum deviation delta P and delta E to be 25% of the computed value of P and E respectively, the minimum value of the factor of safety is. Okay, I will write first of all, what is factor of safety? What is the formula of factor of safety? That is the ultimate load. Ultimate load divided by what? The allowable load. Ultimate load by allowable load. Okay, so now they have asked about what? The maximum deviation delta P and delta E, right? So delta P and delta E, that is to be 25% of the computed value of P and E respectively. So that we can write like this, equals to ultimate load is 1.25 P and the allowable load is 0.75 P. 0.75 P, that is 1.67 P. How we I have written this one, right? So they have told here 25% of the computed value of the P, right? So that is I have increased the value 1.25, okay, and respectively, and I have increased here means I have to decrease here. Next one. So the next is maximum load. Maximum load, that is the ultimate load or ultimate load, that is P plus delta P, P plus delta P, that is the 1.25 P, right? 1.25 P. Now minimum load, what is the minimum load? How you have to calculate minimum load or allowable load? Or allowable load, allowable load, minimum load or allowable load equals to how much? P minus delta P, P minus delta P, that is 0.75 P. okay, so now how we have to answer this question? Now what they have asked here, the minimum value of the factor of safety. What is the minimum value? What is the minimum value now, right? So what is the minimum value? That is should be the 1.67, right? So that is a 1.67 is the answer for this question. Next, the ratio of longitudinal stress to strain within the elastic limit. Longitudinal stress to strain, this is very simple question, that is a modulus of elasticity, right? If a, next question, composite bar. Composite bar means two different bars, 1 and 2. Composite means they are together, they are connected. Steel and copper, right? Steel and copper is heated, both will be heated. Remember these points. Then the copper bar will be under. To understand this concept, let me take this sketch and remember this concept forever. You have to remember, this is a copper and this is a steel, steel and copper. Now what they will do, coefficient of thermal expansion of copper is more. First of all, copper coefficient of thermal expansion is what? More than the steel. Okay, 1 minute. Steel, more than the steel, right? So copper will try to expand, this copper will try to expand, right? It will try to expand. Here it is fixed at the one end, it is fixed, other end is free. It will try to extend from in this direction, in this direction, right? But in expansion will be restrained by the steel, because both will move together by same amount, right? The steel will restrict that one. Steel hogakodala, steel adakke kattkon bitide, adakke hidkon bitide, right? So that together by the same amount, so the composite bar, so therefore the copper will be in compression. So the copper will be in compression and the steel is in tension. Simple concept you have to remember. You can see steel is in tension force and it is in the compression force, right? So the answer for this question is none of the above. The tension, shear or torsion, it is in the compression. Next question, the strain energy stored in a spring, right? Spring, when subjected to greatest load without being permanently destroyed, is called, if you applied the load on the spring, greatest load without being permanently destroyed, what we call that one? That is, we call it as the proof resilience. Proof resilience is nothing but strain energy stored in the spring when it has the subjected to the maximum load, that is a proof load. So what is proof load? It is a greatest load that the spring can carry. For example, this is spring, right? Either it may be any type of spring. What maximum load it can carry, right? That is a, we call it as an proof load. Proof load. Proof stress is the maximum stress in the spring when subjected to proof load, right? And the spring constant or stiffness of the spring is load per unit deflection. It is expressed in Newton meter or kilonewton meter. Next question. A lift of weight W, lift of weight W is lifted by a rope. right? For example, this is lift, right? And here, okay, it is like this, right? And this is a rope. This is rope, right? Rope with an acceleration F. The acceleration F. If the area of the cross section of the rope is A, area is A, the stress in the rope is, first of all, we have to understand the data given. Let mass of the lift be M. Weight of the lift is W, that is W is equal to M into G. Mass into acceleration due to gravity, where G is the acceleration due to gravity and acceleration of the lift by rope is F. Area of the cross section of the rope is A. Now you can understand easily by this free body diagram, right? So the if lift has an upward acceleration, this is the force in tension and this is mg plus mf, right? That is the acceleration due to gravity and acceleration due to the lift of that rope, right? It will like this. If mg minus mf, if lift has an downward acceleration, it is upward acceleration and it is downward acceleration. Then Ft is equal to mg plus mf. You have to add both. Then the stress on the rope we can calculate. Ft by A, mg plus mf by A. So we will get this one. Right? Very simple. You have to understand. One is upward, one is downward. You have to remember these two and you have to put this formula. Right? These two formulas you have to remember. You will get the answer for this question. So the answer for this question is, that is the A, W 1 plus F by G by A. Next, a material which obeys Hooke's law is subjected to direct stress at its elastic limit. Which of the following statement is true? Okay, let me share you the concept. Remember this one. Maximum shear stress, right, tau by E, that is a Young's modulus and this is a Mohr circle. Tau max is tau naught by 2 and here and here. For linear elastic material, strain energy is this formula. You have to remember. Okay, so strain energy is equal to tau by E maximum, that is a tau naught by 2 or delta square by 2e into volume. Okay, so the answer for this question is, that is the all options are correct. Okay, please read the next question, right? Read and answer me. What is the answer for this question? Right, what is the answer for this question? A beam is defined as structural member subjected to what? Can you tell me what is it subjected to? Can you tell me how it is subjected to? Either it may be axial load, right? Or axial transfer load or transfer loading or none of the above. Which one? See, transverse loading. How it is the transverse loading? See, beam is a structural member subjected to transfer loading, that is bending moment and shear force. If we have bending moment and shear force, then we can say that is a transverse loading. Ties, struts, shafts and beams are all one dimensional or line elements where the length is much greater than the depth or the width and have the different names depending upon the main actions they are designed to resist. Ties and strut uniaxial tension and compression. Shaft resists the torque, beam resists the bending moment and the shear force. So the answer for this question is the what? Transverse loading. Next question. This is very very important question. All of you please be careful while answering this type of question. Let me start. A compound bar consists of two bars of equal length. 1, 2, equal length. Steel bar cross section is, this is steel. Steel bar cross section is 3500 and that of brass is 3000 mm square. these are subjected to compression load, that is 1 lakh newton, and ES is equal to 0.2 newton per mm square, and EB is equal to 0.1. The stress developed are, now remember, so this is a condition they have given, steel, and this is copper, the steel bar. So they have given AS is equal to 3500 mm square, right? So the load they have given here, brass bar here, copper. Now force in tension PS, force in brass bar PB, stress in steel bar is tau S, stress in bar is tau B. So the P is equal to PS plus PB. Now from compatibility condition, change in length of the two members will be same, right? So the change in length of these two members will be same, they are assuming. Now this, the deflection, right? What is the general formula? PL by AE. This is the formula. So we are using this formula here. So PS by L, AS by ES, PB by L, EB by EB, AB by EB. So this is the delta 2. Means by solving 1 and 2, PS and PB, we can find out that PS, this is first, this is second, AS into ES, AS into ES plus AB into EB into P. You have to remember these two what formulas. How we have created these two? We have created using this deformation, right? Or change in length we have to calculate by normally. Now, so using those values, we have to find out the separately, right? We have to put that value, that is the PS, AS, ES, right? And AB, EB. You have to put the values here. And stresses in the bar, PS by AS, right? Stresses in the brass bar, it is in the steel bar. We have calculated all. Now, the beam composed of more than one material, rigidity connected together, because those two are, they are connected together. So as to be behave as one piece are known as composite beam. So now the, what is the answer for this question? They have asked you about the, what the stresses develop. They are asked the stresses develop, right? So the answer for this question is that tau B is 10 newton per millimeter square and tau S is 20 newton per millimeter square. What we have calculated here, right? After taking the these PS value and PB value, right? Are you getting the point? What I have done, right? In this question, first I have written the all the given data, right? In exams, you don't have time to write all this given data, but you have to write in the rough sheet so that you can easily solve this type of problem. They may ask this type of problem in KPSC AE level, okay? Next question, right? First you have to write the what given data. After that, you have to using this formula, you have to create these equations too, and you have to find out the PS and PB. Then you have to find out the stress. Total four steps. Next question. The greatest load which a spring can carry without getting permanently destroyed is called, it is already repeated question, right? So it is called as proof load. If the Young's modulus of elasticity of the material is twice its modulus of rigidity, then the Poisson's ratio of the material. Young's modulus is formula is 2g plus 1 plus mu, right? So 2g is equal to g, 1 plus mu, e is equal to 2g given. So the mu should be 0, 1 plus mu is equal to 0. So the answer for this question is what? D, that is a none of you, because the answer is 0, right? Have you understood this? This is the equation you have to remember. Next, the load on spring per unit deflection is called load on unit deflection, right? Unit deflection we can say that is an what? That is a stiffness, we can say, right? Stiffness of the spring, it is a load per unit deflection. It is expressed in newton per meter or kilonewton per meter. Next question. For a validity of a principle of superposition, material should behave in which manner? Material should always be behave in which manner? that is in the linear elastic material, it should be behave. So what is the superposition principle? If there is a linear relationship between load and stress function, then resultant stress function at that point due to multiple loading is equal to the algebraic sum of effect of individual loading, right? So this is a one point you have to remember. Second one, stress functions which we have linear relationship with load are deflection, angle of twist, slope, stress strain, shear force and bending moment. Third point, since load versus energy relation is non-linear quadratic, and superposition theorem is not valid for the energy. This is the first one, second one and third diagrams. You can see strain energy in PL by 2AE, right? And this is PL by 2AE, the second one, and this is the strain energy, the third one, right? So the answer for question is linear elastic is the answer for this question. Next, gradual applied static load do not change with time. Gradual applied static load do not change with time. There, what? That is the magnitude, direction and point of the application. So the all options are correct for this question. Static load is any load that applied gradually. Static means that is the gradually. Does not change its magnitude, direction and the point of application. For example, dead load. Dynamic load means the maximum load at a one time period. Right? With the maximum load they will apply, which is applied suddenly, rapidly and changes its magnitude and direction with time. Wind load, earthquake load. Okay. So next question. Composite beam is composed of two equal strips of one of brass and other is steel. If temperature is raised, this question is repeating always. KPSC, definitely it will give another question on this one in upcoming exam of WRD. Right? So the answer for this question is steel experience tensile forces. Just in the sketch only previous, just 4-5 question back, I have already explained with you the with the sketch. Right? If you didn't watch, please rewind this video and you can watch that one. Brass experience compressive forces and composite beam gets subjected to couple. So all the options are correct. Right? If you want, you can take this one that I have already explained in the previous questions. Right. Next question. A linear force deformation relation is obtained in material. Linear force deformation relation is obtained in which material? That is, we get in the what? Obtained in material having linear elastic stress strain curve. Linear force deformation will get in where? That is a linear stress strain in the curve. Next question. The ability of a material to absorb energy till the elastic limit is known as. Ability of material to absorb energy till the elastic limit is known as what? Right? This question again repeated. This question already repeated, I think, right? So that is a what? Proof, resilience we can say. Right? This one already explained, right? In the previous question. Resilience is what? What is this sketch? We have to take all those things. Right? If you didn't watch, please rewind this video and you can watch. Next question. If a material has the identical properties in all the direction, it is said to be identical properties. Identical properties. Right? So that type of material we call it as, that is an isotropic material. So isotropic material we call it as when it has the same elastic properties, that is E, G, K, mu in any direction to given point. Means in all the points this will be same elastic properties, that is the glass, brass, aluminium, copper and steel. If properties are different in different direction at a given point, then it is termed as anisotropic. Very important point, anisotropic, that is a wood is an example for this type of material. Homogeneous means it is when it the same in elastic properties, it has the same in elastic properties at any point in the material. If you break it any point, that is a homogeneous. Isotropic means when it has the same elastic properties in any direction to a given point. Example, wood, iron, aluminum and steel. Okay. Right. Next question. If all the dimensions of a prismatic bar are doubled, the maximum stress produced in it under its weight will be. prismatic bar means two different type of material. Maximum stress produced where? It is always produced at increases by two times. How? Right, this is one bar and this is second bar. Right, this is L and this is 2L. Let the unit weight of the material is this one. A1 and A2 be the cross sectional area before and after. Right, this one. Before change in dimension, maximum stress is this one. After change in dimension, it will get this one. So hence there is twice increase in the maximum stress in the prismatic bar. Next question. The yield moment of cross section is defined as the moment that will just produce the yield stress is what? Right? What is that yield stress? That is the outermost fiber of the section. Yield moment of cross section is defined. Moment that causes the extreme fiber yield and produces yield stress is called as the yield moment. And within the elastic limit, bending moment has a relationship with the bending stress, that is Fy as is equal to this one. You have to remember this sketch also. Okay, so I think we will stop here and we will continue in the next class about the different questions. If you are new, first of all, if you are new to our YouTube channel, please like, comment and share. Like, comment and share and subscribe our YouTube channel to get more videos like in the future. Okay, thank you and all. Thanks for watching our video. Thank you and all.